Hey everybody, Tim here with today's episode of Star Trek Deep Space Nine, Season 3, Episode 10, Fascination. It's fascinating. So, this episode actually is not that fascinating. Like, it's kind of interesting, and it's kind of quirky, and it's kind of funny, but overall, it's a little bit disappointing. So, this episode has the return of Lwaxana Troi, one of my favorite characters. Like, I love Lwaxana. She makes the next generation for me. And this is her first appearance on Deep Space Nine after The Next Generation has ended. So it's kind of interesting to kind of see where she's going since that show. So basically this whole episode just kind of boils down, like it's a really cute episode and it has a lot of great moments, but the plot is not very thick. Like it boils down to, it turns out Lwaxana Troi has this kind of, it's not really a disease, but it's a condition that mature Beta Zeds get, where she basically starts inflicting her emotions onto other people. And so, like, it's clear from her last appearance that she has the hots for Odo. And when she comes near Odo, it instantly starts again. And she kind of gets a little headache, and then you see people around her start getting little headaches. And then because she's in love with Odo, all of these other characters start falling in love with other characters throughout the episode. And basically, that's the whole premise. That's it. That's the whole episode. I could end this video, boop, right there. It's kind of an interesting episode because we see, like, Kira and Brashear start falling in love. Dax and Sisko. Oh, God, who else? There's a whole bunch. Jake starts falling in love with Kira. And then Vedric Borel makes an appearance, and he starts falling in love with Dax. So it's like all of these, it's not even a triangle at this point. Like, it's like a decagon. Like, there's so many different people. And it's kind of funny because you see all of these characters start making, like, they're not acting themselves. It's almost like a mirror type episode because they're all being inflicted by this thing. And that's the whole premise of the episode, is just seeing these characters not act like themselves. But otherwise, like, so the acting is fantastic in this episode. Any episode, anything that has Majel Barrett in it is gonna be great. But overall, the writing for this episode was not super deep. What makes this episode stand out, though, is Deep Space Nine is known for being that dark and gritty, like, series in the Star Trek franchise. This episode is one of those breaks. Like, you're watching the Dominion, you're watching the Maquis, you're watching the Cardassians, you're watching the Bajorans, you're watching all of this stuff go on, and you're just, like, sitting there, like, you need a break. Like, you're getting battle fatigue from watching this. And then this episode comes out, and like I said, it's fantastic acting, but it kind of lets you breathe. You kind of sit back for a minute, and you're like, okay, like, that was kind of cute, that was kind of fun. And then you go on. And then the next time, we're going to be like, okay, who's blowing up what now? But overall, so I don't have too much to say. I love Majel Barrett. Like, if you always see, like, the Facebook memes or whatever, like, if you could sit down with one person that has passed away, who would it be? And people are always, for whatever reason, go for, like, political figures. I mean, we're all geeks. If you're watching this channel, I assume you're a geek. But it's like, for me, my number one was always Michael Crichton, because he's my favorite author. Like, I have every novel he's ever put out. He started getting a little political towards the end of his career. But, like, honestly, and even Gene Roddenberry, like, I love Star Trek because I'm doing these videos, but, like, Gene Roddenberry, like, I love Deep Space Nine. Gene Roddenberry would have hated Deep Space Nine. So he would have been fun to have a conversation with. For whatever reason, like, if I could hug any person, like, I feel like Majel Barrett would have given great hugs. Like, she just seems like that motherly, grandmotherly type that's just like, come here, tell me all your problems. And she just seems great. Like, I would love to have met Majel Barrett. So I know some people watching this are not necessarily on the older side, but have been around for a while. We'll put it that way. Have any of you met Majel Barrett? What was that like? Just let me know, because I would love to hear stories of people that have met her. Like, I've met a lot of Star Trek actors that are still around, because I go to Comic-Con a lot. But for her specifically, if you've met her, please let me know, because I would love to hear what it was like, to get a real perspective. If you guys have comments on this episode, like, what did you think about it? Did you think it was a nice break from the tension? Did you think it was fun to watch? Do you like seeing Lwaxana in Deep Space Nine, those little crossover moments? Go ahead, let me know in the comments below. Thank you guys for everything. You guys are all amazing. I will see you guys next time for the two-part episode, Past Tense.